Hi, my name is Ekaterina Pavlova, and you intentionally or accidentally came to the Slavic Hub. Holiday season is there, and we finally can brush this year away and hope for something good. Therefore, my today's video is a proof that good things happen. Origins of Dead Moroz are far away from its modern picture of a kind old man with a wild beard in a coat who gives presents to kids on New Year's Eve. During pagan times, Moroz or Marok was the humanization of winter, the terrifying lord of snow. Ancient Slavs, especially kids, would be scared of him because he is able to freeze people or hit with his staff if he is angry. A lot of snow during the winter meant that the harvest in the summer will be great, so for pagan Slavs, Moroz was necessary evil. People would often try to appease Moroz by leaving food and gifts for him at the forest. This character started to shift to the good side with time and technological progress. A few decades later, in 1840, the winter spirit appeared as a wizard in a tale Moroz Ivanovich, or Father Forest in English, by poet Vladimir Adayevsky. In this tale, Moroz Ivanovich is a wise and fair old man who rewards people for good deeds and, in this particular case, punishes for laziness. This tale changed how people would portray the winter spirit. However, no one would look forward to meet him in person, even after that. At the same time, in 19th century in Russia, Moroz started to appear as a Christmas postcards, and his personality started to blend with Saint Nicholas. Postcards were extremely popular at that time, and it finally revealed kind, soft, and generous side of Dead Moroz, who started to come himself to houses and to give presents to kids. After the October Revolution, Dead Moroz and the Christmas tree were actually prohibited for political reasons, because they were associated with Christmas, which is a religious holiday. But, New Year and Christmas already were in people's hearts. During this time, Soviet citizens would still secretly get Christmas trees and make performances with Dead Moroz for kids. Dead Moroz would be played by a male family member with homemade props. Epic Dead Moroz comeback was in 1935, when Soviet regime announced New Year's celebration with a pine tree for kids in a government newspaper Pravda. Dead Moroz became essential part of New Year's celebration and approved by the regime later. This time, the Soviet regime made sure that Dead Moroz had no religious background and updated the canon. Around 50s, Dead Moroz started to appear at the celebration as a kind wizard who gives presents, with assistant Snegurochka and forest animals to make great show for kids. And you know what? Everyone loved it. Everyone loved it so much that you can't imagine New Year without them now. Now it's Snegurochka's turn. Who is she? Forever young, cheerful, and kind woman. Snegurochka has roots in 19th century, when Ostrovsky published a play called Snegurochka, where she was introduced as a daughter of Dead Moroz and Spring. This play is based on a story in the Slavic folklore about a girl who was built like a snowman from snow and came alive. Even her name has a root Sneg, which simply means snow in Russian. According to this tale, she melted, in this case died, when she went jump over the fire, which is pagan ritual, with her new friends. Well, not everybody as fortunate as Olaf, I guess. Also, this origin has its own origin. Do you remember when I mentioned that ancient Slavs tried to appease to Moroz? Unfortunately, young pretty women are always the target. There are so many young women who froze to death in Slavic forests for this reason. Damn. Also, in this tale, Moroz Ivanovich, or Father Forest, please check it out in your free time. This girl who was sent to the forest, it's a sugared up reference to this practice. Oh, I don't know how to correctly call it. In 19th century, Snegurochka was a popular character in Russian art. There was an opera by Rimsky-Korsakov, Snegurochka, based on the Ostrovsky's play, and many paintings, as well as poetry about her. She suddenly became a granddaughter of Dead Moroz during the Soviet period. The regime wanted to keep morals, and she seemed to be too young for being a daughter of a senior. Now, when kids ask, "Mom, Dad, who are your parents?" parents are confused. The answer is just because. Currently, Ded Moroz and Snegurochka are a vital part of New Year's celebration and popular character in the Slavic media, like movies, TV, and cartoons. Stores are filled with their merch, like candies, toys, postcards, costumes, and etc. since fall each year. Ded Moroz and Snegurochka both have residencies with legal addresses for kids to write them a letter with their wishes and for visiting. City's winter holiday activities always going to have their performance. Different ethnic communities in Russia have their own versions of these characters. In short words, holiday season becomes truly magical with them. And here is your Christmas story about something that started as horrifying and turned out to be a miracle that everyone looks forward to. Do you have analog of Ded Moroz and Snegurochka in your culture? Let me know in the comments below. Merry Christmas and fantastic New Year! Like, subscribe, and stay in touch until the next episode. Bye! See you next year!